Today, ECI Victoria is sitting down to discuss the emerging themes coming out of all trial sites across Australia in relation to the NDIS, but more in particular around the Barwon region. So, Anna, with that in mind, if you wouldn't mind talking us through five key learnings and misconceptions that have come across your visit to all the trial sites.
Sure. Obviously, there's a lot more than five, but I'll talk about some critical ones today and also the ones that we're sort of seeing a trend in questions coming through our inboxes.
Yeah.
So I'll start with communication, because I think communication has been a really big theme, the importance of communication, not just, of course, for families getting ready for the NDIS, but within organisations, across organisations throughout the community.
Both internal and external communication.
Of course, yeah. So communication is obviously critical, and as I just mentioned, with a variety of people involved in the NDIS transition. And communication really needs to extend in the circumstances of the NDIS to your local butcher. When we're talking about inclusion, we want everyone on
board. To be aware.
Everyone needs to know what the NDIS is. If they're not, it's going to operate as a silo. So I guess what it means for society is critical, and from an outcomes perspective for children and families, but also in terms of business success. So how are you going to communicate within your organisation, all levels of staff, about what you're doing for NDIS transition and what that means for service delivery? But I guess I wanted to go a couple of steps back, because I have noticed that when we're talking about NDIS readiness, we're jumping straight into business transitions, marketing, all of these terms which are sort of new to the sector or a bit loaded.
Yeah.
But if we take a couple of steps back, and this really came out from, obviously, we've recently moved offices, and all of those people in our office are mainly, you know, tech startups, social entrepreneurs. No one from our sector. And so I remember the first day we were there, I was in the lunchroom, and someone asked where we were from. And I started talking about this Early Childhood Intervention Australia and this National Disability Insurance Scheme, and I either saw sort of eyes rolling back into people's heads or just a look of confusion. And I went back to my desk and realised that we know what intervention is because we work in the space, and the conversations that we have daily are about the same thing. But no one outside of us knows what that means. And when we're talking about families that are really early on in the diagnosis process, or maybe just having some concerns around their child's development, and you start talking about intervention, and then you throw in this National Disability Insurance Scheme, it becomes quite obvious why there's challenges around engagement with services and around acceptance of the journey on that pathway for families. So in terms of communication, we need to go backwards a few steps and start communicating with the community about, you know, what service we are, what we do down the road, how we do support families, and be able to package our services in a way that are engaging for families and that makes sense and that they're non-threatening. And when we're able to do that, then we can start putting frameworks around how that looks in terms of best practice.
Sure.
But we really need to go back a couple of steps and start communicating from there. And it's the same for insurance. When I first started working in this space, every time I thought of insurance, I would get some sort of anxiety about when my next car payment's due. There's a difference between private insurance and social insurance. Social insurance is all about investment, and that needs to be understood as well by staff, so that they're able to comfortably convey that to families.
It's important that we're not intimidated by the words. And try and disassociate them with things like,
of course,
life insurance, health insurance, car insurance.
Yeah, but if you think about it, the first time you've heard the term, you wouldn't have known what it meant, and it would have come with you, you know, you would have come to that with certain perceptions of that word. And I know from my background in social work, intervention is not always a positive word and does not evoke positive feelings. In this space, it's a really positive thing, but people come with all sorts of understandings from their journey so far. So we need to go back a few steps and be able to communicate what it is we do in layman's terms.
So it's important the language that we use, both in our internal communication with staff and also external communication with the community, to build an awareness and understanding of the work that we're not only doing as ECIA, as a peak body, but also for all our member organisations and how they integrate with the community.
Yeah, of course. And I mean, a large component of early child intervention is the interface with mainstream settings. So early year learning settings need to know what it is you're doing. When we talk about collaboration, collaboration starts from an understanding, a point of understanding of what everyone's doing and the value in that. So if we don't explain that, from the get-go, it's going to be a challenge. And I guess the NDIS is an opportunity to sort of rebrand and talk about things from the start again.
Yes.
In a whole new way.
Yeah, no, that's exactly right.